Thursday morning on the Radio Vision Network. I am Mark Cook, and I am pleased to be joined this morning by Joel Richardson from Soul Joel Productions. Joel, good morning. How are you today?
I like how you threw a little soul, a little swagger.
Listen,
into soul.
If you're going to come up with a name like Soul Joel Productions, you gotta say it with some soul, right?
Absolutely. Good morning.
Thank you. Good morning to you. So, and thanks for coming back.
Thanks for asking back. It's always
a good sign. Joel was on a couple weeks ago, and,
you
know, it is a good sign when you're invited back. That means that you did something right?
Yeah, exactly.
So the reason that you're here is that we want to talk about a couple events that you've done in the past and then a couple events that you have coming up. So let's start off with the event last week. So I saw some pictures. I heard a little bit about it. It sounded like an awesome event.
We had over 700 people at this in my grandmom's hometown, which is obviously my dad's hometown. All four of my grandparents are from there. And
What town? It's
Uniontown. It's like an hour south of Pittsburgh.
Okay.
Did this historic, like old vaudeville type theater. It's really good. We raised money for five different charities. And as it turns out, my dad planned a business trip because it was my birthday. It was also my niece's birthday. And my dad had to go to Cleveland and Connecticut. So he thought, why not come? So he ended up coming to the show. It was our fourth show that we've done in that particular theater.
Okay.
Now, my dad has been married three times, and he's also been divorced three times.
Okay.
Twice since my mom.
Okay.
And that's why I do comedy.
Right. All right. That makes sense. It's perfect.
Now, my first stepmom, my dad's second wife, if everybody's following at home.
Yeah, they're taking notes.
I'll do a family tree and what branches fell off. Anyway, I'll slow the jokes down. So, good morning. So anyway, my stepmom couldn't make the last couple shows, but she talks to my grandmother all the time and had planned on making it to this past Saturday.
Okay.
And all of a sudden now my dad's planning on coming, and he's like, I got to hang out with the comedians. I don't want to, like, my ex stepmom.
Yeah, I don't want to hang out with my ex.
And she had planned to pick up my grandmom from her house. So he's like, this is unbelievable. He's like, I can't believe, why are they even friends? Why?
Yeah.
And she tried to extend like the olive branch, where she texted my dad and was like, hey, I lost your mom's number. Could you send it to me? It's like, you don't think I talk to my mom?
Yeah.
You don't think I talk? I know you guys talk almost every other day.
Oh.
What do you mean you lost the number?
It's yeah.
Like, you talk about cell phones. Like, you save your contacts.
Yeah,
like,
right.
I don't think you really lost it. And my grandmother's in the phone book. You know, she still has the rotary phone. It's not like you can't look that up.
Right.
You know what I mean? So my dad's like, all right, listen, I'm getting a hotel room. I'm not staying at my mom's house. I don't want to avoid it.
Right.
So my dad came in early, went like backstage, hung out with the comedians. My stepmom comes in. We haven't seen her, I didn't realize, in 18 years. Yeah.
What?
Which was, it was kind of weird, but here's the funny thing. The other comedian that I co-hosted the show with, that's from my grandmom's hometown, he lives in Hoboken now, does comedy full time.
Okay.
His dad got remarried to my ex-stepmom's cousin. It is crazy. It's like, so many different things. So now, fast forward, the show goes great. My dad's now talking to my grandmother and my ex-stepmom in the lobby.
Okay.
After the show, just like everyone else is mingling, talking to comedians, doing meet and greet. Some charities are selling, like, merchandise, raised some money. There was a band. It's a great event, man. Over 700 people.
Yeah.
Like, there was electricity. The people were dressed up.
Raised a lot of money.
Raised a lot
of
money.
It's
great.
That's
and like
great.
I said, when you watch people leave a comedy show, you can see their posture is like their chest is out, their shoulders are up.
Yeah.
Like, it's so much different than when they walk into a show. First thing, well, out of the show, they just spent 3 hours laughing.
Right.
Well, you know, hour plus the band plus the comedy show. So it was a great event. Now we're at the after party.
Okay.
All right. Anybody that got there got a complimentary drink at this one restaurant who's been very good to me. It's Rizza's, right next to the theater, and they get one complimentary drink after the show. Place is packed. My dad's talking about meeting up with my ex-stepmom. I'm like, I've seen this one before.
Yeah.
Everybody's watched Jerry Springer.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, it's going to get weird.
Yeah, what's going on here?
I'm sitting there, and then we go, and I'm talking to a couple of charities that hired me, how much they enjoyed it and how I got into it, all these kind of questions. And I see, I mean, drinks are flying.
Yeah.
So now I hear last call, and I got to get off the phone. I was on the phone, and I go over to my dad, and I was like, listen, I'm not going to block you, but we did drive together. I was like, I think everybody I know knows what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
I was like, am I going home alone?
Right.
Or are we? Do we have someone coming with us?
Yeah.
Should I leave you here?
Right.
And he's like, nah, man, I'm cool. So I walked back over, talked to the people that I was talking about. They were thanking me again. They're adding me on Facebook. And my dad comes and does what I can describe as the truffle shuffle. Like, he actually walked over to me, not even picking up his feet, like he had skis on. Except he's 62 years old. And the guy that hired me to do the fundraiser goes, man, you're a good dude, man. Thanks so much for taking care of your dad. I'm like, he's not disabled.
Yeah.
Like, he's not elderly. He just can't walk.
Right.
Like, do you understand?
Yeah.
And so we end up leaving, and then we're walking. As luck would have it started downpouring.
Right.
And we're going to my car, and I was like, Dad, are you doing okay? He's like, I'll tell you one thing. I'm not doing good at all.
Well, after the night he had between his mom, his ex, you in his ear, I mean, come on.
And then we had breakfast the next day, and I was like, so did you have company? Oh, because, by the way, we were supposed to go to church the next day with my grandma.
Right.
I got dressed, I was showered, ready to go, and I texted him, like, hey, meet you in the lobby. He's like, church is canceled, man. It's canceled.
No. Church wasn't canceled.
He canceled.
He canceled church. Yeah.
Right. Well played.
That is really funny.
So we're having breakfast in the lobby like an hour later when he got it together. I end up going working out, showered clean. So I was right. Sweating out clean.
Right.
And then we were having breakfast after I got cleaned up again and ready to check out of the hotel. And I was like, so how much do you remember from last night? And he was like, everything. I'm like, did you have company last night? And then he had to start scrolling back on what. Yeah, he was doing a little of the texting.
Oh, man. I never would expect to be in a situation where my dad is texting booty calls with ex-wives. Like,
I didn't read them. I don't know.
No, I don't know. You're better off that way. Believe me.
I didn't read the script.
Joel, there's so many different questions I have now. I don't think I have enough time. They're telling me to go to a break, but I have so many questions.
To finish that story, too, right before my dad walked over, the people had said they announced that it was my birthday. Friday night at the Valley Forge Casino, my super fans actually brought me a birthday cake. And they said between my sister and my dad, who were at the show in Valley Forge, that they were trying to keep me out of the area, like, because they had a cake at the
desk. Oh, they surprised you.
They surprised me.
Right.
So, and they announced it Saturday night, and that it was my birthday. So after the show, this girl goes, hey, is May 3rd really your birthday? And I was like, yeah. I was like, I wouldn't make that up. Right. She goes, so is my husband. And then she goes, show him, honey. And he takes his sleeve up, and he has a barcode on, which, by the way, apparently scans Bud Light. Like, it's a Bud Light's barcode, and it says on it, May 3rd. Born on date.
Did you punch him in the face?
All I could say is, welcome to Uniontown, where I'm dealing with my ex-stepmom, which I don't even know if that's a thing. Is that a thing?
Yeah, it's not a thing.
Yeah, so I was like, I'm taking a picture of this. He goes, man, I don't mind at all, but you better tag me on Facebook.
Yeah, Joel, I just stay with us for a few minutes. I need to get back. My head is spinning right now with so much stuff. I love having you here, Joel. This is great. So we got to take a quick break on Morning Coffee. We'll be right back with Joel Rich.
When it's time for Jersey Mike's to make a really great sub, this is what we do. It's what we've been doing. It's what we've always done. It's what we'll always do. So what are you doing? Jersey Mike's. Be a sub above.
Simply Gents, located in Marlton, New Jersey, takes care of all your grooming needs, including haircuts, straight razor shaves, massages, facials, manicures, pedicures, and waxing. To find more information or book an appointment, visit us online at www.simplygents.com. The secret weapon of a well-groomed man, Simply Gents.
Today's show was brought to you by Alicia Kelly of Whitehorse RV Center in Williamstown, New Jersey. Alicia is your RV expert. Contact Alicia at alicia@whitehorsebarbie.com or give her a call at 856-262-1717, extension 203. When you think of RV, think Alicia Kelly.
Got to keep this story going. Joel's telling the greatest story ever about his father, who's been married and divorced three times. This event that happened last weekend. We're talking about ex-wives meeting up with ex-husbands and stepmoms. And
not mine.
No. Yeah. Ex-stepmoms meeting up with with dads and all this stuff. So, you know, I want to get back to one specific thing that you said that really jumped out to me, was that you hadn't seen your first stepmom, which means
there's a second.
Yeah, which is your father's second wife.
Yeah.
Right. You said that you hadn't seen her in 18 years.
Yeah.
So we're talking about a huge amount of time, and then all of a sudden she popped up and was like, I'm coming to this comedy show, and I want to meet up with your dad, and I want to hang out with his mom, and all of this stuff. So 18 years.
What's funny is that there's it's this town, so it's a small town, and I'm bringing New York comedians to this town, so it becomes a big happening, obviously with like 700 people in there. You know, most of the town. It was
awesome. Most of the town was there.
Yeah. So a lot of, like, actually her sister and her brother-in-law have come to almost every show, and they always say how nice I am to them. But, I mean, listen, fans are fans. I mean, they're coming to support the show. The money's going to charity. It's a great night out. So their kids, actually, I guess my ex-aunt, or, you know, step-aunt. I know. We're at the we'll draw a tree. So her daughter came, so it's my ex-step-cousin, and she walks in, I look at it, I was like, Devin, I don't know if you remember me. She goes, yeah, no, I remember you, Joel. And she had since got married, obviously, it's been 18 years, you know, she's grown up now.
Right.
And so all of a sudden, her husband goes, Joel, soul, Joel. And I was like, why do I have this effect on dudes?
Yeah,
like,
right?
Why?
Yeah.
Like, calm down. And I was like, yeah, that's me. And he goes this, right like this, and I quote, I get to meet the king.
The king?
Because it's like 20 miles north of West Virginia, so they got a little bit of that southern dialect a little bit. He didn't even say the king. He said the Kang.
The Kang.
The Kang.
All right.
So I was like, yeah. He's like, awesome, man. He goes, really looking forward to the show. Like, and that's what I'm talking about. Like, that's the kind of excitement that you get at the show. And I love that, man. Like, as much as I'm tongue-in-cheeking a little bit, like, being a little, but like, that is like the
that's the part to get off on. Yeah, that's the best part.
Yeah, that's the electricity that's in the air. And honestly, as comedians and performers, they feed off that in the audience. And you could, you know, as a performer, you could feel that energy.
Yeah, it's something special. I have to get back to this.
Yeah.
So how long were you?
I know you've had a chance to like breathe, digest, let it sink in.
But I'm trying to figure out the timeline here. Okay, so your mom, how long were your dad and your mom married for?
Officially, I think 14 years. 78, they got married, and then 92, divorced.
Okay, so that was a good run. So then
that was a pretty strong run.
Yeah, so when did the next marriage happen?
94? Yeah, my dad went
back. So he got right back on the horse.
Yeah, he had went back to one of his high school reunions, and
nice. Met the one that we're talking about from
Yes.
Okay, so how long did that last?
I mean, if people want to do research, they can figure out names. We're going to keep it anonymous.
No names. So then how long was he with number two?
I think 94 to 98. That was a four-year run.
We'll call that a fling.
We'll call that a school term.
Yeah, that was...
Like high school, college, 4 years.
I shouldn't have even counted.
Yeah, it was...
So then the third, how much...
I think it was another four-year stint.
That's it?
Well, I think he started dating her in like 99 and then went to got married about 2004 and 2003. I'm a little dicey on that one. And
he was divorced by the time the Phillies won the World Series.
2008, yeah. 2007.
What a great year for all of us and not such a good year for him.
Yeah, well,
the third time was not the charm.
Depends on what city you're from. Great for Philadelphia, not so good for the western part of the state.
Yeah, that's a good point. That's a very good point. All right, Joel, I'm going to get out of your family life for a little while, if that's okay. I'm just fascinated. I think I see a lot of humor in it, but I also know that it's family and it's very serious and all that stuff as well.
Absolutely.
You have so many family members that are family members that you probably were like, I never wanted you to be a family member, but now we're family members. It reminds me of that commercial where the cousins meet at the wedding, and if they didn't meet at the wedding, when they were out in the club, there's like that connection, but right. they didn't know they were cousins. It's like,
and you're adding alcohol.
You have so many people out there that you're related to that, hey, yeah. you know, you never know what could happen.
People get amazed at how many friends I have on Facebook. I'm like, well, half of them are actually family.
Yeah. See what happens when your dad gets married and divorced three times?
I'm just collecting friend requests.
Joel, let's get into what you have coming up, because yeah. this is a really cool event you have going on, right?
Yeah,
let's
absolutely. Talk about it. So next weekend, I have May 14th. It's actually the fifth year that I've been doing this with Marlena and Claire. They this year, they're going to be raising money for the MS Society.
Okay,
and
great.
It's going to be over in Haynesport at the catering hall for the Robin's Nest. And tickets are $20. I got Mark Riccadonna, who is a writer for the SNL Weekend Update.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have Kate Wolf, who was on True TV's Dumbest Videos Ever. And she was just on Fox's Red Eye.
Okay.
So she's...
Is she like one of the commentators on the videos?
Yeah.
Oh, so funny. Those
yeah.
people are hilarious.
And she, I mean, she's even better in person. You know,
great.
She's funny on TV, better in person. I mean, that's what live comedy is all about.
Right.
And all the money goes to the MS Society.
That's awesome.
So, yeah.
So let's give details on that real quick. Is
yeah.
that a website?
So, yeah, yeah. SJPcomedy.com is my website. And then the link's going to be up there to buy tickets. And if you use promo code VIP, the tickets are only $15. So,
okay, cool.
So instead of being 20, they'll be 15.
Yeah. And you know, we're talking about $5, saving $5. But really, it's a charity event. So... you know, the money, the extra $5 goes to the MS Society. That's not a bad thing. Hey?
Yeah. And then the following weekend, I'm going to be down in Indian Acres Farm because I'm living the dream.
Yeah.
And it's going to be Friday, May 20th.
Oh, the places you'll go.
All the places. Yeah, exactly. it's Comedy Under the Stars. So
cool.
I got Chris Monty, who was on fourth season of Orange is the New, well, will be on fourth season of Orange is the New Black.
Okay.
He's on Vinyl on HBO. And he was just in Mall Cop 2 with Kevin James.
Great.
Yeah. And
I saw that in the theater.
Yeah.
I don't know why I just admitted that.
Yeah. Well, good for you.
I have nieces and nephews, all right? Yeah. They like movies like that, all
right? We'll be right back after this. So it's going to be Friday, May 20th, and it's BYOB and Bring Your Own Food. So it's basically Bring Your Own Picnic.
Right.
And the tickets for that are also $20. And that will be on my website, sjpcomedy.com.
That's great. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going
to
wrap.
Oh, Mark gets to announce the breaks, not Joel.
Oh, come on now. I'm the host of this show. I'm driving the ship, all right?
What just happened?
Listen, I watched Titanic yesterday. I'm driving the ship right into the iceberg, believe me. So we'll take a quick break. Yeah. So we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back to wrap up things.
When it's time for Jersey Mike's to give a sub some sizzle, this is the way. The way it's always been. The way it always should be. The way it always will be. Because that's just the way it's supposed to be. Jersey Mike's. Be a sub above.
Extra Innings is the nation's premier indoor baseball and softball training center, featuring indoor batting cages, 7 multi-use tunnels, and training rooms. Extra Innings can provide professional instruction, private and group lessons, and the best year-round clinics. Along with a nationally recognized pro shop that features the latest and widest selection of equipment and apparel, our experienced staff can provide you with the right instruction and help you find the best equipment for your ability and budget. Extra Innings, where the game never ends.
Today's show has been sponsored by More Than Gifts. Come see our new location in Marlton, New Jersey. Not just gifts, but more.
Laughs here this morning. We're talking to Joel Richardson. I'm laughing too much. I mean, listen, it's cloudy, it's gray, it's raining outside, but man.
It's sunny here in the morning.
I'm feeling good. I'm laughing a lot. This guy is hilarious. You need to go check out his shows. This guy does comedy all over the area. He sets up these shows and he does them in a way that's, you know, normally connected to a charity or some sort of worthwhile cause. And that's what makes it special. That's what makes it have soul. He is Soul Joel from Soul Joel Productions. And I know that you have events coming up next week on the 14th.
Yep.
And then you have another one the following week.
Friday the 20th. So, yeah.
So let's get real serious. Yeah. You want to get serious? Let's get really serious.
Social media is very easy. It's SJP Comedy, Instagram, on Twitter, and Facebook is facebook.com/SJP Comedy. And our website, SJPComedyForSoulJoelProductions.com. So you can check out all my shows. And the trick is, for all the listeners out there, if you enter promo code VIP to any of the shows, you get $5 off. So it's kind of an incentive to go on my site and buy tickets in advance.
Yeah, that's a great thing. It's a really tricky promo code you came up with there.
Yeah, well, I want to make people feel important.
Joel, you have made me feel important, and that's the main thing I care about.
And it's because I'm friends with Mark on Facebook, along with my former family members.
It's pretty exciting. Listen, if you get the chance to be friends with Joel on Facebook, it just might change your life. It's changed mine. Look at me. I look great. Anyway.
Thanks for having me.
Anywho, so listen, make sure you check out sjpcomedy.com. Go see Joel's shows. Go meet Joel. Joel is terrific. He's great. I thank him again for coming in this morning. I appreciate it very much, Joel. We got to take a quick break, and we'll be right back here on Morning Coffee.